Ladies and gentlemen, if I can have your attention for a moment. You are all very welcome here today to our 2021 conferring ceremony. Before the ceremony commences, and for your safety and comfort, I would like to bring the following information to your attention. There are four exits in this room, one emergency exit to the left and one to the right of the seating area, two to the rear of the room. In the unlikely event of an emergency, we would ask you to proceed directly and calmly to the nearest exit to you. When exiting the building, please do not use the lift. Once outside the building, you are asked to proceed to the assembly point in the car park to the left or to the right of the building. We are strictly adhering to COVID safety guidelines. We would ask that you wear face masks throughout the ceremony and to please remain in your allocated seats. In preparation for the ceremony, I would ask guests to turn off their mobile phones. Please be aware, this event will be live streamed online and photographed. If you can please stand for the graduand procession. Standing for the academic procession.
Please be seated. Ian Erica, a green Ushla file to arrive. Good Ian Charman the shot in a run for Davoctony or Dedekish or Aulamorian Kalashta. Distinguished guests, graduands, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this graduation ceremony at which third level awards will be conferred on learners of Griffith College. I would also like to take this opportunity to welcome graduates and their guests who are joining us today online. Our panel members include Professor Dermot Hegarty, President of Griffith College, Kevin O'Sullivan, Head of the Griffith College Limerick Campus, Ronan Fenlon, Director of Griffith College, Finbar Sheehy, Head of Faculty in a Pharma Group, Brendan Fogarty, Sarah Cuddy, Programme Directors, and the lecturers involved in the delivery of the learners' programmes. I'm Dr. Thomas McGuckagon, the College's Director of Academic Programmes, and I have the pleasure of being your MC for this graduation ceremony. Conthusakor Lesh Dehimokti, Iriminisher and Tullav Dermot Hegarty, Ukhtaron Kalashti Griefa, Lauritling, Herkiana Kalashta. I would like to begin the proceedings by inviting Professor Dermot Hegarty, President of Griffith College, to deliver a conferring address.
distinguished guests, colleagues, graduands, ladies and gentlemen. I'm looking out, and before me, I see a crowd of masked men and masked women. And the thought occurs to me, is all that's missing for each of you is a pair of sunglasses and a hoodie, and we'd have a great set of bank robbers. Hopefully, in fact, we won't be in that capacity for too long more. Hopefully, in fact, we'll be able to burn the masks at some stage. Unfortunately, as things stand, health and safety really require us, particularly at this time, particularly as, in fact, the rate of infections is rapidly increasing. They require us to continue the precautions. But forgive that irreverent thought. This is, of course, a big day, a very big day for you, for all of you. And it strikes me that at this point, it occurs to us that the realization of life's dreams are really like a journey to a mountainous terrain. Each struggle to a new peak is rewarded by a vision, a clear vision of the way ahead. Today, we celebrate your conquering the first peak. Today, graduates, this is your day at the mountaintop. So savor this moment, the vista will give you. Let us joy live in your memory for life. But remember, however, that during these difficult journeys, we are guided by the experience and dedication of others. Your guides were family, partners, and friends who shared your trials and tribulations, who prepared meals for you, who put up with your inevitable but hopefully few cranky moods, and those of you who so readily accepted the stress that you were so relieved to pass on. Those who accepted, not those of you, those who readily accepted stress that you were relieved to pass on. Now, in the time-honored tradition of Griffith College, I'm going to ask the parents, families, and friends to stay seated while the graduates stand up. Now, I want you, the graduates, to turn to your families, partners, friends on either side of you, wherever they are, and convey to them your thanks for the support you've received over the years by acclamation, applause, or cheers, or however you like. Hopefully, for those of you who don't have family, partners, or friends here, they will have heard that applause as they watch online. Now, please sit down. Now, if anybody asks me how the graduation speech went, I should say it was interrupted by applause. Vigorous applause at that. As president of the college, talking about acknowledging support, I have little doubt that you would wish me to acknowledge support of my colleagues as members of board, as heads of faculty, as lecturers, administrators, and librarians, all of whose work contributed to your success today. Today, I would like to look at the COVID landscape to which you have traveled and how it has challenged you and changed us all forever. You faced many trials, including, for some here, the grief of loss of someone dearly loved. We ourselves lost our chairman, Frank Scott Lennon, to COVID last month. He was not just a close friend for over 40 years, but Frank was a mentor and inspiration to us all. We were inspired by his courage and his tenacity in fighting illness for so many years. Also by his piercing objectivity, which was applied to the resolution of many conflicting situations here in the college. We describe our loss in these words: the unrelenting minute he filled with service done, our maker's meaning in it, for so his life was run. Farewell, you Christian soldier, your courage ne'er undone. Rest well, you Christian soldier, for you life's battle won. Many in this audience who've lost close relatives or friends to COVID will understand the depth of grief occasioned by it. Our thoughts and our condolences are with them, and hope, in fact, they will relate to these words. We're currently living a worldwide track that has changed our lives beyond recognition. We never anticipated that a 21-day lockdown, global lockdown, would actually go on for months and turn our lives upside down. We started doing things differently. We needed to be creative and work with what we had. We started witnessing some historic changes worldwide. While COVID engrossed us in its fear, it also helped us see the world with a new lens. We realized the value of our communities. We realized the importance of life, what truly matters in it. We had to unlearn old patterns and realize that happiness lies in little things. Simple things we overlooked months ago, like a hug or calling over to our friends or family. These simple things we took for granted. We now look forward to them every single day. And the pandemic taught us that it is time we appreciate our close ones and be grateful for what we have. It reminded us that life is fragile and that it is time to work together and lift each other up. These past months have witnessed a vast sea of kindness and compassion in our communities around the world. It has led to countless acts of selfless heroism in hospitals and care homes. Among other things, the pandemic has required us all to draw on skills and attributes such as adaptability, resilience, positivity, tenacity, and empathy. We've been so fortunate as well in this time to see our planet heal, if only temporarily. On your graduation booklet, on the inside front cover, you will see two satellite images of Beijing before and during lockdown. Air pollution covering a substantial part of northeast China is indicated in color. You will see beside that image another image showing that a sky is cleared up. Second satellite image shows the absence of pollution. These two images, given the size of the area covered, shows the impact of pollution on our planet, especially when you multiply them by 10 or 20, allowing for all of the major areas of conurbation throughout the world. On your graduation booklet, on the back cover, you will see that as we withdrew from our homes, wildlife took our streets with no fear of losing their lives. Again, here you will see the image of a fox wandering through Grafton Street in broad daylight. Grafton Street is the main shopping area in Dublin. Imagine, in fact, Patrick Street at Christmas. Grafton Street would normally, on any day, be mobbed. And I don't think you'll see a fox travelling with ease through Grafton Street again. I wondered where was he heading for. Perhaps I thought it might have been the Bailey, which is a well-known Dublin pub, or in a better-known pub in County Dublin is Johnny Fox's, but I'm not sure he was heading there. Anyway, I suspect nobody told him the pubs were closed. The pandemic's most important lesson is taught us that nature heals itself and we should not take it for granted. Our planet is all we have. We cannot exploit it more than we have already. I would like to welcome, if I may, our distinguished guest, Kieran O'Donnell, TD. Kieran was elected TD for Limerick City in 2007 and 2011. He's currently chairperson of the Oireachtas Transport and Communication Committee and a member of the Budget Oversight Oireachtas Committee. He was appointed Deputy Spokesman on Enterprise, Trade and Innovation with special responsibility for enterprise employment in October 2010, having previously been a spokesman on finance. Kieran has served as Vice Chair of the Public Accounts Committee, member of the Banking Inquiry, and as a member of the Oireachtas Finance Committee. All of these functions, of course, fitting for a qualified chartered accountant. I have to say, my great pride, in fact, in welcoming Kieran, is as an alumnus of Griffith College, I think he suffered in the class from under me. And it's a great privilege, in fact, now to see Kieran as a senior member a senior member of, in fact, of our Octus. Kieran is married to Phil and has four children. He's a qualified accountant, as said, with many years' experience in his own practice. He's a special interest in disabilities, as well as promoting Limerick City and Shannon Airport and the region. May I revert, if you like, to you and to the pandemic. In a very short period of time, in 2020, you had to adapt to an entirely new way of learning due to the COVID pandemic. Gone was the ability to sit in lectures and labs with fellow students. Isolated at home, online classes required you to become more independent in your study and assignment work. And it's a testament to your adaptability that you survived and thrived in this independent way of learning. These skills will serve you well in your respective careers. Your learning will be lifelong as you independently upskill and your field changes over the coming years. When the learning skills forced on you by COVID will serve you well. As the COVID generation, you have largely had to acquire these valuable skills yourselves, and nobody can take these from you. COVID pandemic also affected how we work. When COVID first hit, businesses and enterprises that could adapted to an entirely remote way of working, including innovative ways of customer service, such as five-star restaurants transformed to food trucks. Many of these changes are here to stay. I'm not sure about the food trucks, but certainly remote and hybrid working are here to stay. COVID has also seen rapid innovation, particularly in the medical field, with the advent of mRNA vaccinations, originally developed for COVID, now being trialled for malaria and HIV vaccines currently under development. There have also been innovative changes in education. One such innovative educational challenge is the expansion of apprenticeship-type learning from traditional trades to administrative and professional work. The major challenge in relation to apprenticeships is to change people's attitudes to them. People consider apprenticeships as only relevant to the trades, and in particular the building trade. Whereas in countries like Germany, leaders of major multinationals, having hundreds of thousands in some cases of employees, those leaders started their lives as apprentices. Griffith is already the education provider for two national apprenticeships, one in healthcare and the other in bar management. Allied to this are the development of micro-credentials, which are awards for individual modules of courses, allowing learners to learn at their own pace, to try courses in a different field, or to enhance their skills further. Your COVID-acquired skills ideally place you to exploit micro-credentials. On the national front, Ireland has been held up globally as a shining example of determination and solidarity, how as a society we face COVID head on. Clear messaging emanated from government and health authorities, followed by the imposition of appropriate restrictions, eased and reimposed in a fluid fashion as circumstances required. The common focus and lack of divisiveness was heartening and reassuring. The government approach seeking buy-in rather than being heavy-handed, as in other jurisdictions, elicited a very positive response, resulting in a high level of compliance with sometimes extraordinary restrictions. And we're actually seeing the result of, in fact, that lack of buy-in in the various riots you are now seeing on the news in continental countries. But all of this aided us to flatten the curve and allowed for the gradual easing of restrictions. But now, as the number of COVID infections increase and increase rapidly, we need to resume this buy-in. We need, in fact, to be very conscious that our approach of voluntarily taking on ourselves these restrictions has worked for us, okay, and we need to make sure that it continues to work, so let us hope we don't have a lockdown over Christmas. The various financial support schemes, costing over 12 billion since the start of the pandemic, have demonstrated to us the value of solidarity. Your mission is to pass on these lessons of solidarity, agility, resilience, empathy, tenacity to the next generation. In this respect, this year's graduates are in good company. Griffith students have won external awards across all faculties, including in accountancy, ACCA first place in the world in the subject strategic business reporting. That student scored 94%, the highest mark worldwide out of 8,395 students. Another student in photography won the Gallery of Photography Graduate Award in 2020. Two other students won the S Media Photographer of the Year in 2019 and 2020. A former student, and now a graduate, basically won the Public Relations Institute of Ireland Young Communications Professional Award of 2021. A student, current student, won Video Journalist of the Year Award. In our, among our film studies, a student won Best Film Documentary Short at the Prague International Indie Film Festival. Another, Best Film at the LGBTQ Toronto Film Festival. Another, Best LGBTQ Documentary at the Venice Shorts Film Festival in 2021. Another student won official selection at the Indie Shorts Awards in Cannes, well-known international film festival. Another, official selection at the Montreal Independent Film Festival. A design student was shortlisted for Future Makers Award by the Design and Craft Council of Ireland. And finally, another design student is shortlisted for the Institute of Designers in Ireland Graduate Design Award. This is a measure of the achievement of the skills and achievements shown by your fellow students. They are not unique, and we look forward to watching your careers and seeing similar distinctions achieved by you. Who knows? Maybe one of you might be chairing the PAC committee of the Oireachtas. As regards your career prospects, and normally we would at this stage, talk to people about the economy which they are entering, and many of you have jobs already, but a number of you will be seeking jobs in the Irish economy. Well, take comfort that growth in the Irish company is never, an Irish economy really is extremely, going extremely well currently. Seldom has the market, the labour market in which you enter, being so much an employee's market. There are plenty of jobs, and there's plenty of activity in Ireland. Evidence of this will be from the news that Ireland is on the shortlist for billions of euros investment by Intel, and also by the increasing number of high-growth tech companies setting up in Ireland or continuing to scale up their international operations already established in Ireland. Examples of recent new investments include the advent of TikTok and Riot Games, opening a new broadcast and content production centre in Dublin, the Irish-led Sonry raising 50 million for cloud security platforms. Announcements of new jobs in IT and in the pharmaceutical sectors are regular occurrences almost on a weekly basis. Limerick is no exception to this success. Announcements of new investment in the region are now becoming commonplace. Edwards Life Sciences is the most recent avail of all Limerick has to offer. It brings 250 new positions. The city has a pace and a dynamism not found elsewhere in Ireland, or so my wife tells me, who comes from Limerick. Limerick has been named European City of the Future in its population category, as well ranking first for business friendliness and foreign investment strategy in its population category. It was recently included on the Atlantic Edge European Embrace. And this represents a new dynamic brand for Limerick City, which will promote it nationally and globally as a growing destination for inward industry investment, tourism, education, and as a great place for people to live in and work in. And the city now has a student population of 21,000. As the college celebrates its 15 years in the heart of Limerick City, we're happy to be part of this dynamic and to contribute to the ongoing success. We have a word of warning, though, for those of you who now enter the workforce. You have been used, in fact, to functioning online. You have been used to relating to people through your computer. And we want to now to prepare you for the meeting in the company meeting room. A couple of rules we're going to offer you. One, Do not attend in your dressing gown. You'll be unable to turn off the camera. Rule number two, do not share with your colleagues that your boss is talking rubbish. You'll be unable to go mute. Rule number three, do not point out when you're physically attending meeting that the sound is all clear at your end, for fear they'll ask you, how are your hearing aids? Number four, do not make faces in response to ridiculous suggestions by your boss. You can't go off video. Number five, at the office meeting, don't offer to switch on sharing where you're physically present at the meeting. Rule number six, do not offer to host the meeting, particularly if it's already been chaired by your boss. And rule number seven, lest you feel tempted, where you can lay your hands on a document to say, oh, it wasn't attached. Just remember that you might have been given that document 15 minutes earlier, physically, in the meeting. So this is the world of the office, the world where you will actually, in fact, the world we are resuming, and hopefully will resume on a permanent basis, though temporarily we find ourselves, in fact, working back at home at the request of government. But ultimately, we are back in the office, and just bear in mind that, in fact, habits we may have formed while working online may not serve us well. We are back in campus, and I wish to extend a warm welcome to our computing, engineering, and Innopharma graduates graduating here today, and their guests, and indeed the programme leaders, Brendan Fogarty, John McDonough, and Finbar Sheehy. Today, our students receive awards from Qualifications and Qualifications Ireland, Quality and Qualifications Ireland, apologies, and from BTEC Pearson. The awards range from certificate to master's degrees. And a number of our graduates here today are Chinese, and a number of them are watching online. So I would urge any of you who expect to function successfully in the commercial world in the 21st century to visit China and indeed to learn Chinese. To our Chinese graduates, may I say, Jin Jian, Woman Fei Chong Gao Xing, Qin Dao Le, Woman Zhongguo, Shu Sheng De, Jia Jiang He Cheng Yao. Jin Jian, Wo Xiang, Ni Men De Fu Mu Shuo, Ni Men Zai Ireland, Shu Xi Fei Chong Nu Li, Ying Wei Yo Ni Men, Zhongguo De Wei Lai, Ar Gong Jia Mei Li. To explain, I've just welcomed the Chinese families and friends, both here and online, and stated they should be proud of their sons' and their daughters' achievements. To our Indian graduates, Baharchi Chatro, Me Apka or Apke Ka Walunka, Swagart Kartun Ha, Kartahun, Swagart Kartahun. To our Nigerian students, Ma Pibeta Naija, How far? How are you today? No wahala. May I also thank our Brazilian students for their contribution to Griffith College. Obrigado por sua grande contribuição a Griffith College. To our German students, wir begrüßen alle unsere deutschen Studenten und ihre Familien, die gekommen sind, und gemeinsam mit ihnen zu fahren. To our Polish students, witamy ciebie, swoje drogi I przyjaciół. Well, I've spoken at length about the challenges you have faced over the last period of your study, so certainly the last 2 years of your study. But just as you've had to face your challenges, so we in Griffith have our challenges. And key to the value of your award will be our national degrees becoming, first of all, Griffith College degrees, and ultimately university degrees. Griffith College degrees under delegated authority to make our own awards, which we expect in the near future. But there should follow from that university status now open to the Institute of Technology through amalgamation. And given our size, it should also be open to us. We too have to have faith, but we have a strong politician on our side. Back to you. Just as you glimpse the world from your current mountain peak, may I express the hope that over your period with us, Griffith will have found a place in your hearts as you have in ours. I want you to know you're always welcome on campus, socially, educationally, or just to show off the new BMW. May I conclude by congratulating you on your success and by wishing you may harness the knowledge and experience that you acquired here in Griffith College to achieve what you richly deserve, a successful and fulfilling career. Thank you.
Iriminish, Erin Chakthadala, Kieran O'Donnell, Lars Linner Kemaha. I would now like to invite TD Kieran O'Donnell to address the graduates.
Thanks very much. Apologies for being late. I was getting the train down from Dáil Éireann. So firstly, Professor Diarmaid Hegarty, and President of Griffith College, it's an honour to be here. I've come here many years. And I am a former alumni myself. And I was just reflecting on it, really. I would say probably a substantial portion of chartered accountants in Ireland are former alumni of Griffith College. I attended then NIHE. I then went and worked with a firm in Cork, VF Nathan and Co, and did chartered accountancy. And we would have all attended classes, but it was standard with Griffith College in terms of the quality of the lecturing. We all did 4 weeks blocks before the exams in Dublin, in Griffith College, as it was then. And I would have to say it was probably the most intense 4 weeks I ever spent in my life. We all qualified. And I think that set the standard, really, for what Griffith College is all about. And I want to compliment Professor Hegarty for that. And I think that's coming through in what the standard of education you're getting at Griffith College today. And you know, it's, you're going out into a world, and I suppose just reflecting back on your speech, Professor, that the whole issue of COVID, we're going to live with COVID for another substantial period of time. It's going to be a feature of your working environment and college environment if you go on, some of you go on to do further studies. But there's negatives and positives. I think one thing it probably has done is that it's made graduates more immersed in applied. They have to think for themselves a bit more. And I think you're far more ready for the working environment. Many of you will step into jobs. And, you know, I think that's a positive feature. The negative feature is the remote, the lack of that interaction in college. It's now coming back, but it was a feature throughout all third level institutions, and more particularly on Griffith College. But I think that's about to change. I want to, I suppose, wish you well in your careers. And I suppose the advice I would give really is, number one, have a career path. It can always change, but decide on what you would like to do over the next 3 to 5 years. Take your time in the type of role you take up, what you would like, whether it benefits your career, and above all, enjoy it. You must have a career that you can make a living in, but you must have something you enjoy. If you enjoy it, you will excel. And that's something, you know, from that I would have certainly learnt over a lifetime. But I'd slightly differ with Professor Hegarty on his speech on about remote learning. I think people working when they get straight up and working in their dressing gown, that's going to become a constant feature, right? And we have that throughout all our houses, and it's something that I think will not. It's something I don't like, but it's going to be a feature, I think, of the modern environment. Can I just talk about really? I want to congratulate Griffith College. You'll be 50 years in 2024. You'll be 15 years in Limerick. The fact that Professor Hegarty is married to a Limerick one is an added bonus. I'd say she brought a lot of strengths with that Limerick resilience. You're living in a real thriving city. There's huge opportunities out there. You made reference to companies like Hibbert Life Sciences. There are many others, Regeneron, and there's new jobs coming into Limerick with Legato, their new company formed. Their huge offer is to stay here. That was not a feature maybe 20 years ago. If you choose to stay in Limerick and work here, that is now a very much a realistic option. And that's something that I'm very proud of, being a public representative here over many years, that we can say that. It's a vibrant city. Yes, we have challenges. We have challenges in the city centre, in terms of Georgia and Limerick, and just renovating it and bringing it up to par. But in terms of job creation, we have an awful lot of positives, and I think at times that may be overlooked. And when we look at it in terms of our sporting city, well, we are now very much a city of the culture and the arts, and very much a city in terms of job creation. In terms of, and like, I would say Griffith College started from an acorn. I think Professor Hegarty's ambition to become a full level university, I would not in any way bet against you getting that, because I think that's the type of institution, third level institution, that you are. You've always maintained a very high standard. And I note that your genesis here was through the Midwest Business Institute. I lectured there. I didn't get the opportunity to lecture for Griffith College. I had spent many years lecturing here in Limerick when I first set up in practice, across a range of institutions here, LIT, it's now TU, UL, various institutions. And it's something I always enjoyed. But I think the most important thing here is that you go out of here from today, you have a fantastic qualification, but it's only a start. The other difference today is people are now lifelong learning. You're going to go into careers where you will do further studies, masters, some of you already have. People may go on to do PhDs, go on to do further qualifications. And the other thing as well, I think there is a dynamic shifting of change happening now. I have people that I meet now that may have qualified as quantity surveyors in other areas. They're going back to do what would be regarded as traditional apprenticeships, electricians. And I'm very, very excited about apprenticeships. It's an area I believe that will evolve over time. And first, I agree, made reference to the German model. That's a specific model. I think it's something that's evolving here. And it's something that needs to be grasped. So I suppose, in summary and finally, I want to wish you all well. The class of, is it 2020, 21 or 21? Both. So class of 2020 and 2021. And I want to also acknowledge your parents and families here today, which play a huge role in your studies. Without them, I don't think it would be possible. And you might give them a round of applause. I think that's important. And really, I suppose, the future is very bright. I look forward to continue to work with Griffith College, and certainly in that ambition to become university status. Your standards are so high. They're, as I said, they're at that level already. And I think really the challenge now is, do we have a model of education around that's completely inclusive? Everyone gets opportunities. But more particularly, that you're going out from here today knowing that everything is possible. So thank you all very much.
Anish, while in Fáilte Cor Raibh, Gudi and Quinshod the Nocaid, in a run for a colleague, the Náisiúnta, agus Idr Náisiúnta, Vic Lane and Coláiste. I now welcome you to the part of our proceedings at which national and international awards will be conferred on learners of the college, and I declare open this awards ceremony. Iremer and Tullev, Dermot Hegarty, Uchtaron Coláiste Gréfa, Colliacht the Náisiúnta agus Idr Náisiúnta Vrunna, Erna Fowlamori, Atadar Herbert, Egan Galashta. I call upon Professor Dermot Hegarty, President of Griffith College, to confer awards on the learners of the college presented by the college for that purpose.
Before I actually utter the words of conferring, I'd just like to explain to you the significance of this moment. Before doing so, may I express my thanks to Deputy Donald for his very kind remarks, very, very kind remarks about Griffith. I really appreciate those, and the encouragement that you've given us today. One always needs encouragement to go forward, to achieve one's ambitions. I'd also like to thank him on your behalf. I thought, in fact, the words that he spoke to you were very encouraging, and the advice that he gave you in terms of pursuing careers that you will be happy with, that you will have a focus on, I think was very, very relevant and very, very helpful. So thank you for that, Deputy. This particular moment is the moment of conferring right now, and let me explain its significance. You may have noticed that in my earlier address I referred to you as graduands, which is a Latin gerund, those in course of graduating. As of this moment, or the moment of conferring, you become graduates because your awards are conferred upon you. That's not to say you haven't earned them already. Quite clearly you've earned them through many hours of study, mental toil and diligent application. And you've also earned them through the various assessments that you have passed. But it is actually the moment of conferring is when, in actual fact, you now can refer to yourself as a bachelor or a master. So I'm going to actually, first of all, confer you in the Irish language. And for the benefit of those of you who do not have Irish as a mother tongue, I'll also do it in English, okay? Har cian caloistí grífa, agus corlea diáve calíctá agus calíctí éireann, brinam calíctí ar fiáli mórein caloistá, atá ílóhar agus nach vili lóhar, a bhín caidan amach ílechna calíctí agus írum gugurtar na fiáli mórei féim avroid. On behalf of Griffith College and Quality and Qualifications Ireland, I hereby confer the awards on the learners of the college, both here and in absentia, who've achieved the standards determined for those awards, and I ask the learners be presented to me.
Iramanish er Brendan Fogarty, Stiorahor Clore, Irahori Herbert. I call upon Brendan Fogarty, Program Director, to present candidates in respect of the college's computing programs.
Distinguished guests, President of Griffith College, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to congratulate those about to graduate from the Computing and Engineering Departments of Griffith College, Limerick. Carpe diem, or seize the day in English, is a quote from one of my favourite movies, Dead Poets Society, a film about an inspirational teacher. It would be fair to say that, in order to graduate, that you all had to seize the day in terms of your studies. You have managed to complete your studies under circumstances that, due to COVID-19, were more difficult than normal. When you first attended induction, some of you were apprehensive, some were excited, whilst others were unsure if they were pursuing the right course of study. It is great to see that so many of you overcame your fears, put in the hard work, completed your studies, and are now about to graduate. Whilst you have acquired various skills during your studies, you have also learned, for example, in my computing classes, that sometimes one and one does not equal two. I will remember with fondness your enthusiasm, your quest for knowledge, and our informal chats before and after class. Your qualification will greatly assist you in the pursuit of further studies, or in acquiring employment in local industry where Griffith College has created strong links with both computing and engineering companies such as Dell, Regeneron, AMCS, and Johnson & Johnson, amongst others. Lastly, congratulations again. I, as Program Director, and all of the lecturing team are very proud of your achievements and wish you every success in the future. And to finish, I will leave you with another quote from Dead Poets Society: make your lives extraordinary. What you can go on to achieve in your lives has no limitation. And we here in Griffith College Limerick look forward to hearing your extraordinary success stories of each and every one of you. So, President, I present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed their programs and who are worthy of their BTEC and QQI awards. So, from the BTEC program, Higher National Certificate in Computing 2020, Rui Santos. The QQI Award of Bachelor of Science Honours in Computing Science, Christopher Chamberlain. Darwin Estefano Vieira Machado. QQI Award of Master of Science in Network and Information Security, Afiz Abiodun Adeyemi. Aluwafemi Ajagbeje. Onye Akachi and Ye Alechi. Kingsley Chinoso and Ye Alechi. Abidun Awole. Nitesh Hanamchet. Ekoso Emmanuel Imad Odor. Congratulations. Ike Chukwu Isaiah Imo. Moses Inwang. Abdul Jalil Isa. Macmillan Niasha Maramba. Congratulations. Chinen Wenya Nawubufu. Samuel Nawa Chokwu. Moiwa Ibrahim Ogwande. Congratulations. Well done. Yusuf Olawemi Oladejo. Asha Rampura Chandrash Ikar. Sriharsha Sitarama. Abedon Oluwatsen Siombo. Charles Uchek Ukwu Ugwu. Mandela Chokokwe Okpe. And now we have our 2020 graduates from the MS in Network and Information Security. Enwa Chokwu Greg Ekpi Monwu. Charles Chinonwe Onokwa. Robert Bardonal. the QQI Award of Bachelor of Engineering in Industrial Engineering, Edston Batista Marquet. John Brennan. Well done. Joseph Daly. Well done. David Hartigan. Leonie McNamara. And now we have our 2020 graduates from the Bachelor of Engineering in Industrial Engineering. Declan Dowling. Kieran McCarthy. Stephen Lyons.
Iriminish er Finbar Sheehy, Stjórahor Dáiva, Lauert Lenar Kemaha. I call upon Finbar Sheehy, Head of Faculty, to address the graduates from the college's Innopharma Griffith College Pharmaceutical Science programs.
President, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, graduates, friends, delighted to be here this afternoon for the graduation from the Innopharma Griffith College Faculty of Pharmaceutical Sciences. This is actually the first graduation from this faculty in Limerick, and absolutely delighted to be here. My first job, my first career was in Limerick. I worked in analog devices as a test development engineer in Raheen. I lived on the road in Clarina. My wife is originally from Singland Road, so a lot of grow back in the city. Collaboration between Innopharma and Griffith started back in 2014 to provide a combination of technical, business and transversal skills and competencies for those who want to work in the life science sector. And the medical industry is very, very strong, as Dermot said earlier on, it's very strong in the Midwest and has made a significant positive contribution either in terms of economic development, investment or jobs to the region. Today, obviously, we're welcoming graduates from the 2021 Postgraduate Diploma in Medical Device Technology and Business. And obviously, delighted to give you an opportunity to have an in-college graduation and possibly an opportunity to meet some of your classmates, maybe from the very, very first time. Many of the graduates from the faculty are currently working in the life science industry, either in medical device, in pharma, clinical research, and obviously been working tirelessly for the last 18 months in roles across the entire supply chain, whether it's roles research and development, technology transfer, manufacturing, clinical trials, sourcing, production, quality, distribution, regulatory affairs, and medical healthcare areas as well. And obviously your contribution has been very, very significant and greatly appreciated. We live in a strange time, a time where the disruption of COVID has accelerated the digital transformation of business and work. This transformation has also highlighted the need for lifelong learning and the development of new skills to navigate this disruption. You managed to do all of this as part of your learning while studying under very challenging times. whether it's in class but mostly online, across geographical, experiential, cultural and virtual boundaries. You also did this whilst managing your jobs, contributing at home, managing illnesses or other personal or family challenges. I want to congratulate each and every one of you on your success. It was a pleasure, it was an honour to work with each one of you, and wish you success in your future and offer you any support and assistance we can provide. Congratulations again and well done.
Irminish Sarah Cuddy, Stjórnarhóir Clár, Irahori Herbert. I call upon Sarah Cuddy, Programme Director, to present the candidates in respect of the Innopharma Griffith College Postgraduate Diploma in Science in Medical Device Technology and Business.
President, I present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed their programs and who are worthy of their QQI awards. Postgraduate Diploma in Science in Medical Device Technology and Business. Stephen Hayes. Kenneth Malloy. Congratulations. Aaron O'Halloran. Congratulations. Brian Waugh. Congratulations. And Louise Cusack.
And as we conclude our conferring of awards for our graduates here present today and those attending online, we might give a special round of applause to all our graduates to wish them well in the future. Tá anna hosig an glóis to dúse of runner ar falamor of win bar fiaushabach in a good lane. The college now has the pleasure of announcing a prize to a learner who's achieved excellence in his or her studies. And this year, the prize is being awarded in respect of the BEng in Industrial Engineering. I would ask the recipient of the prize to come to the platform and be presented with the prize by Professor Dermot Hegarty. The best academic achievement on the BEng in Industrial Engineering is awarded to Kieran McCarthy. Ian Erica, a green uishle, Kurum Kreatleshin Sharman Ashok, Kondavakthani of Runa, or Aulamorian Kaloshta, Baron Buerkes Liv Galair. Distinguished guests, TD, ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the ceremony for the purpose of conferring awards on the graduates of the college. My best wishes and thanks to you all. While the graduates are here with us, I'd like to take this opportunity to briefly mention the Griffith College Alumni Network. With over 40,000 graduates living in Ireland, Europe, and in over 120 countries worldwide, The network is an excellent way to stay in touch with classmates, fellow graduates, and the college. The network is also proving to be a valuable resource for recent graduates seeking or changing employment. As we move towards the college's 50th anniversary, we're also delighted to see our graduates from earlier years using the network to employ and recruit graduates for their own organisations' needs from Griffith College alumni. Details of the network are available on griffithalumninetwork.com and on the college's website. Finally, we would like to thank all our graduates and their guests for your attendance here today and for attending online. For those who are attending in person today, we regret that we're not in a position on this occasion to invite everyone to stay back indoors and mingle together and celebrate over drinks and refreshments as we had planned and hoped. We recognise that health and safety must remain our first priority, and thank you for your support and compliance under these continuing particular circumstances. For now, we wish all our graduates every joy and happiness in celebrating your success with your families and friends today and in the days ahead. As a token, as you leave the stadium today, we've small boxes of chocolates for everyone as you head your separate ways. In the future, and hopefully near future, we look forward to meeting you again on campus without restrictions as you continue to develop your successful careers. In the meantime, please stay safe and well. Please stand for the academic procession.